Help! Help! They're pushing me! They're pushing me!
On!
I need to stop! Oh no! Look out up there!
This mainland run was a catastrophe.
I'm sorry, sir. I really am.
Oh, Morris, none of this was your fault. It was some troublesome trucks and a dozing signalman that caused the problem. You just weren't strong enough to pull the load. You have tried your best from what I've heard. Still, it's best that we get you back to the New Dan Railworks to be repaired. Well, that's a little bit of a problem. You see, we've accidentally recycled the blueprint of Morris's design. Oh, that's interesting. You and all the other blueprint keepers are fired. Yes, sir.
Well, I guess that means I'm off to the scrapyard tomorrow.
Don't talk like that. Why would I ever scrap you? I'd never give up on any of my engines, unless of course they're lazy, but that's not the point. You are definitely not a lazy engine, so you're not going to the scrapyard, no matter what it takes. So therefore, I'm sending you back to the UK so you can get a redesign. In fact, you'll also get a new number too, and a new whistle. So guess what? This isn't too bad for you now, is it? You know what? You're right. This is kind of exciting. In fact, I think I'm gonna change my color too. I'm not a fan of this black paint anymore. Makes me feel like, well, a discriminator. I think I'm gonna be red like Jermaine and Justin. That's my favorite engine! Ha ha! Now your ferry leaves tomorrow at 9, so I suggest you be ready to go first thing in the morning. You know I will, sir. I cannot wait!
Morris will be here any minute. I wonder if I'll recognize him. I think this might be it. My goodness! Morris, is that you? Or has Justin gained extra wheels all of a sudden? What do you think? My opinion doesn't matter here. It's your opinion that I want to hear. Well, I absolutely love this redesign. Thank you so much, Mr. Grant. Don't mention it. Now you better get to work, because there's still a railway to run. Yes, sir. Besides, the world's not going to end anytime soon.
Now this is gonna become a masterpiece. Something smells good. I wonder what it is. Oh, hello Ronald. What are you doing?
Oh, hello Morris. Well, I'm cooking.
You're cooking? Well, how do you even do that?
My dear Morris, haven't you ever heard of the phrase, practice makes perfect?
That's not what I meant. What I mean is, how are you actually cooking? Like, you don't even have hands.
Oh, well then, I guess the fourth wall does get broken quite a lot.
Oh, well, good point. Anyway, what are you cooking?
Some homemade soup.
Oh, yum. What flavor? Carrot? Tomato? Chicken?
Nope. Cornflake.
Cornflake? Well, but why?
Well, since cornflake tastes good as a cereal, I thought it would taste even better as a soup.
Well, okay then. So anyways, I'm guessing you're gonna find someone to taste test the soup for ya.
Yep, and I think I found just the engine for the job. You!
What, me? Oh, well, okay then. Here it goes.
Wow, this actually tastes good.
Wait, are you for real? Here, let me try some.
Wow, it actually does.
Well, that's a success in my opinion. What do you say, Ronald?
Sounds good to me.
Wait a minute. In reality, engines don't eat, right?
Uh-oh.
It's too late now, lass. No one can help you.
Have no fear. Jermaine the Brave is here.
Oh, for the love of BNSF. Cut, cut, cut. Jermaine, are you sure you're well enough to be a part of this movie?
Yes, of course I am. The only reason why I coughed was because I swallowed a fly.
Jermaine, we sprayed fly repellent around the area before we started filming, so I don't think you actually swallowed a fly.
Well, mosquitoes are common around here, so he might have swallowed a mosquito.
Well, it's not like mosquitoes can harm us engines. I'm gonna be fine, trust me. Never mind that now. What we need to do is finish this scene for my movie.
Fine, but can I first take this sword off my head? It makes me look like I stole a feather from an elderly cockatoo.
Well, if it makes you feel that way, then it can stay that way, because you're not taking that sword off your head!
Gee, okay, gosh, no need to let out your anger like that.
Sorry. Anyway, Kieran, before we start filming, can you come and check on the lights, please?
Okay, coming!
Well, even though I can't fully reach them, I can see from here that they look fine. They haven't been touched at all, you know.
Well, that opinion will have to do. Anyways, take two's coming up. Light crew, get out of there. We are on in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hold everything.
Nate, what are you doing here? We didn't invite you to be a part of this movie, you know.
I'm here on cop duties, and I got a report from Bullrose Doc saying that some studio lights have been stolen. And I think those ones that you're using might be it. Kieran, since you're the closest one to them, what do you have to say for yourself?
I'm sorry to say, Nate, but I wasn't the one who stole these studio lights. In fact, I didn't even know that they were stolen in the first place. And I also wasn't even the one who set these lights up. It was Tito, the director, who did all this, not me.
I see. Thank you for your cooperation, Kieran. Well, Tito, start talking!
Well, the reason why I stole these studio lights was,
Get back here, you studio light thief!
I feel so uncomfortable right now. Okay, who agrees that we shouldn't pretend that this never happened?
I do.
And especially I.
Then a cockatoo engine like me is especially okay with this.
Huh.
So, Mick, what are your jobs for this morning?
Oh, nothing much, really. I'm just delivering these containers to Bullrose Docks and then dropping off these general goods to Trixton Junction.
Well, I'm not doing too much either. All I'm doing is just delivering eggnog to all the villages in the country.
Why would you be doing that? It's only November, you know.
It is?
Of course it is. Didn't you check your calendar this morning?
What's a calendar?
You know what a calendar is. A calendar is a booklet that shows you all the months of the year.
It is?
Of course. How could you not know that?
Know what?
What a calendar is.
What's a calendar?
I just told you what a calendar was.
You did?
Yes, just as we finished talking about what our jobs for the day were.
We're doing jobs right now?
Yes, don't you see the trucks that we're coupled up to right now?
We're coupled up to some trucks?
You just said you were delivering eggnog to all the villages in the country.
I did?
Yes, don't you know all of the villages in Newden?
What's a village?
How can you not know what a village... You know what? I give up. How about we forget all of this? Besides, some people do prepare for Christmas during November.
You know what? You're right. Let's forget about everything we have just discussed.
Yes! That would be lovely. Thank you so much. Now I can just relax until it's time for me to go.
Wait, what's Christmas and what's November?
Thrills and spills on the railway, it's a life of happiness. But sometimes impatience can lead to carelessness. Sometimes we take chances, ignore the danger signs. Fate can surprise you with no reason or rhyme. Make sure you learn your lesson, you'll know best time. Accidents happen now and again, just when you least expect, just when you think that life is okay, fate comes to collect. Accidents happen now and again, when people or trains get smart. Just like that. Accidents happen now and again.
the thing that you're doing, whatever you're doing, is not what you're thinking.
Excellent!